Hey, hey guys, this is Luna Miao, and you're watching Jammin' Music Man. Yeah!
What's up, guys? It's me, Jammin' Music Man, and with the Halloween season upon us, I thought I'd make a video giving you guys my picks for horror movies you should watch Halloween night. So sit back and relax, because you guys are in for a scare. Alright, you guys, these first two picks, I feel like a good majority of you people know these horror classics, but for me, for years now, as a tradition, I always watch these two movies on Halloween night, and my first pick is the original John Carpenter's Halloween. I mean, what more can you say about this? This movie is a classic. This movie is legendary. This movie came out in 1978. This was the film that put Jamie Lee Curtis on the map and John Carpenter on the map as well. But, you know, basically the plot of the film is about Michael Myers. He kills his sister as he's a kid. They send him off to a mental institute, and he returns back to his hometown, Haddonfield, Illinois, like 15 years later. And his doctor, or psychiatrist, Dr. Loomis, he's trying to stop Michael Myers from killing people in his town. Little does he know that he has a sister that he doesn't know about, and which is played by Jamie Lee Curtis. And, you know, Jamie Lee Curtis, she's a high school student. She also babysits for money. But this movie right here, a classic, like I said. And I feel like this movie right here kicked off the whole slasher craze that took off after this. But if you haven't seen the original Halloween, you gotta check it out. And after I get done watching Halloween, I always pop in this next film, and this is a classic, one of the all-time greatest zombie films. I think you guys know what I'm talking about. They're coming for you, Barbara. Look, there's one of them now. I'm talking about George A. Romero's Night of the Living Dead. I love this movie. It's a classic. It's in black and white. This movie came out in 1968, and you know, one of the greatest zombie films of all time. I mean, what more can you say? Basically, the plot of this film, it's a about all these strangers who, you know, block themselves in this house as, like, you know, there's these zombies everywhere and they're eating people. And basically, these people are stuck in this house and they're trying to figure out how the hell they're going to get out of there. But it's a great film. You know, there's no real blood, gore, violence or anything like that. You know, it's definitely a scare. If you've never seen it, I highly recommend checking it out. But those are my first two picks, Night of the Living Dead and John Carpenter's Halloween. All right, you guys, this next horror film right here, I feel like a good majority of you have seen this film or at least heard of this film. It's a definite classic, and it's a definite watch on Halloween night. That's the original Texas Chainsaw Massacre from 1974. If you haven't seen it, you gotta go check it out. Basically, just to sum up the plot of this film, basically about this group of like college age kids. Two of them are brother and sister, and they're trying to take their friends to their aunt and uncle's old homestead so they can take a swim, relax, have a good time. And they're in this van, and they end up picking up this like crazy hitchhiker guy who's a little bit strange, and he slices his hands in front of them thinking that he's going to impress them. So they're all freaked out and they kick this hitchhiker guy out of the van. But little did they know that this hitchhiker guy was a part of this crazy, messed up family in some small town in Texas. And as the film goes on, one by one, all these kids end up getting hacked off, of course. But I remember the first time I watched this, way back in the Halloween season of 1997, I had to get my dad's permission at the video store so I could rent this film. But, you know, at the time, you know, I was into, like, Halloween, Friday the 13th, Nightmare on Elm Street. But this film right here was definitely different from all those films, because, like, Nightmare on Elm Street, it had a little bit of humor to their horror. This film right here was dark, gritty, disturbing, and when I first watched it, it freaked me out. But it's a definite classic, and I highly recommend checking it out Halloween night. That's the original Texas Chainsaw Massacre. Alright, you guys, these next two horror picks I got, one is a remake, and one is another horror classic that I highly recommend watching Halloween night. And this horror classic right here, it came out in 1982, and it was directed by Sam Raimi. You guys know what I'm talking about. I'm talking about Sam Raimi's The Evil Dead. If you haven't seen it, you gotta check it out. Basically, the plot of this film is about this group of young adults. They want to, you know, escape from the city life and spend a weekend in the woods, and they're finding this cabin. And once they find this cabin, they find that there's a basement. Down in the basement, they find this old book, and they also find like a tape recorder with this guy who had lived there before. And throughout the cassette tape, he's telling, you know, of the things that he went through with this book. But little did they know that this book that they found would set off these demonic spirits that would take over their bodies. And it's a fun horror film. You know, it's one of the few horror films that captures, you know, gore, horror, special effects, and comedy all in one. And of course, this film made Bruce Campbell a cult hero. And of course, this was the film that gave Sam Raimi, you know, his start. And of course, Sam Raimi would go on to direct the Spider-Man films. But I definitely love the Evil Dead franchise. I love 1, 2, and Army of Darkness. And the remake that came out a few years back, it wasn't that bad. But, you know, I love the original more. But it's a definite fun watch for Halloween night. And the next one, I love this remake, one of my all-time favorite horror remakes, and that's The Blob. The Blob, the remake came out in 1988. The original Blob came out back in like the 50s, that starred Steve McQueen. But the star of this film was Matt Dillon's brother, Kevin Dillon. But basically, the plot of The Blob, it's about like this meteorite that lands in this small town. And little do people know that this meteor that hit this town contained like this ooze, and the ooze just keeps getting bigger and bigger, and people start dying. But this remake right here has a lot of gore, you know, 80 special effects that the 50s version didn't have. But I highly recommend checking out the 1988 remake of The Blob. All right, you guys, this next set of horror picks are all films directed by legendary Italian filmmaker Lucio Fulci. And Lucio Fulci was known for his horror film style. He made a lot of zombie horror classics. But these films right here are some of his all-time greats. And one is one of my all-time favorite horror films of all time, bar none. But the first one is my personal favorite, Zombie. And if you haven't seen this, I highly recommend checking it out. Basically, the plot of the film is, it's about this woman. Her father has gone missing. She hasn't seen him in months. He's like a doctor. So this woman, she ends up meeting like this reporter guy, and the reporter wants to help her find her father. So their journey takes them to like somewhere near like the Bahamas, and they end up meeting like this couple who, like, you know, they live on this boat. So this couple befriends them, and they find this like island, and hoping to find her father. But little did they know that on this island, you know, people are dying and coming back to life. And you know, it's a classic that I highly recommend checking it out. And there's like this big problem with the title of this film. In Italy, this film was known as Zombie 2 because Dawn of the Dead of 1978 came out in Italy, and it was known as Zombie. So when this film came out in Italy, it was Zombie 2. So that's the whole big misunderstanding with that whole situation. And in England, this film was known as Zombie Flesh Eaters. And I believe this film was like banned for a while in that country, I believe. But Lucio Fulci, you know, he made some, you know, zombie horror classics, but this is one of my all-time favorites. I know you can get this on Blu-ray now. This was put out by Blue Underground. Blue Underground puts out a lot of like great, cult classic horror films. But this one, I definitely recommend checking out, Halloween Night. This next one right here, House by the Cemetery, another great Lucio Fulci film. Basically, the plot of this film is about this family. They move into this new house in somewhere in like New York City. But next door to the house is like this cemetery that's allegedly haunted. And in the basement of this house, there's a casket buried up under the house. But, great film, great gore, great special effects that I highly recommend checking out. That's The House by the Cemetery, directed by Lucio Fulci. And this next one right here, another great Lucio Fulci film. It's City of the Living Dead. Basically, the plot of this film, it's about this priest and this woman. They find out that the gates of hell have been opened, and they got to stop what's going on, because zombies are taking over the world. But it's another great horror zombie classic that I highly recommend checking it out. And Blue Underground put this film out, but I highly recommend checking out these three Lucio Fulci classics. All right, you guys, this next pick right here, I chose it because we lost Sid Haig here recently, and I chose it just as a memory of him. But this film right here is one of his most iconic roles as Captain Spaulding. This film came out in 2002, and it's Rob Zombie's first film. I think you guys know what I'm talking about. I'm talking about House of a Thousand Corpses. If you've never seen it, I highly recommend checking it out. And I gotta say, this is probably one of Rob Zombie's best films he's ever done. But basically, the plot of this film is about these two young couples. They go on this road trip to find this local legend of Dr. Satan. That's when they stay at this house where this murderous, psychotic, cannibal family lives. And of course, the father of this family is played by Sid Haig, with his role as Captain Spaulding. It's a fun film. It's one of those few horror films that capture comedy and horror and gore, and like I said, I highly recommend checking it out. And if you've been down in the dumps since the passing of Sid Haig, you gotta whip this one out. This is a classic, A House of a Thousand Corpses. All right, you guys, this next film right here, I would consider more of a sci-fi psychological thriller with a little bit of horror. It came out in 2001, and it's became a cult classic, and it's one of Jake Gyllenhaal's early movies. I think you guys know what I'm talking about. I'm talking about Donnie Darko. And if you haven't seen this, I highly recommend checking out. Basically, the plot of this film, Jake Gyllenhaal stars as Donnie Darko. He's like this oddball outcast kid who goes to like this private prep school with his sisters. And, he's kind of obsessed with like time travel and the end of the world. And there's also this giant sized bunny rabbit that's telling Donnie to do all these like bad things. And while the film's going on, there's all these other events going on, like the 1988 presidential election between George H.W. Bush and Dukakis. That was going on. And Donnie Darko, he also meets this new girl in school that he kind of has a thing for. And it's a really, really out there kind of film that you have to, follow along with the film to see how it goes. But it's definitely a cult classic, and definitely one you should watch on Halloween night. That's Donnie Darko. Oh, and also, I actually met Beth Grant, who stars as, the mother of one of the daughters with the little dance group. Trying to remember what the name of that dance group was in the film. I actually met her a few years back, and I did a video, and it's here on my channel. But just want to let you guys know that. But definitely check out Donnie Darko. All right, you guys, and my final pick for horror movies you should watch on Halloween. This film right here is one of the most disturbing, most gruesome, most banned movies in the history of cinema. I think you guys might know what I'm talking about. I'm talking about the 1980 classic Cannibal Holocaust. And if you decide to watch this film, viewer discretion is advised. It is a very disturbing film, but basically the plot of this film is about this guy. He's trying to decide whether or not to air on national TV of this found footage of these filmmakers who end up going to like this Amazon jungle, and they're documenting their time with like these Amazon natives. And throughout the film, as he's watching this footage, you know, he finds some disturbing moments during their time in the jungle. Some of the female natives, they end up getting raped. There's some death scenes with some animals, and also the filmmakers, they end up getting killed themselves. But it's a very, very disturbing film. When this movie came out in certain countries, it was banned. I know it was banned in England, and I know the filmmaker and some other producers of this film, they were actually taken to trial because in certain countries, people actually thought this was a legit snuff film. Now, I will say, the animal death scenes, those were real. Now, you know, some of the death scenes with the actors, I wouldn't say they're real. Some people might say otherwise, but definitely the death scenes with the animals, that was real, no doubt about it. But you guys have probably heard me talk about this film here on my channel over the years, but when I first watched this film, I just found it very disturbing. It was one of those films I had always heard about for years, until like a couple of years ago I watched it. But you know, if you've never seen it and you do decide to watch it on Halloween, you've been warned. But guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you guys check out some of the picks that I gave you. Be sure to give this video a like, comment, and subscribe. Link to my Twitter, my Instagram in the description box below. I'm Jammin' Music Man, and I will see you guys next time.